Early the next morning, Joshua brought the tribes of Israel before the Lord, and the tribe of Judah was singled out. Then the clans of Judah came forward, and the clan of Zerah was singled out. Then the families of Zerah came forward, and the family of Zimri was singled out. Every member of Zimri's family was brought forward person by person, and Achan was singled out. Then Joshua said to Achan, "My son, give glory to the Lord, the God of Israel, by telling the truth. Make your confession and tell me what you have done. Don't hide it from me." Achan replied, "It is true. I have sinned against the Lord, the God of Israel. Among the plunder, I saw a beautiful robe from Babylon, 200 silver coins, and a bar of gold weighing more than a pound. I wanted them so much that I took them. They are hidden in the ground beneath my tent, with the silver buried deeper than the rest." So Joshua sent some men to make a search. They ran to the tent and found the stolen goods hidden there, just as Achan had said, with the silver buried beneath the rest. They took the things from the tent and brought them to Joshua and all the Israelites. Then they laid them on the ground in the presence of the Lord. Then Joshua and all the Israelites took Achan, the silver, the robe, the bar of gold, his sons, daughters, cattle, donkeys, sheep, goats, tent, and everything he had, and they brought them to the valley of Achor. Then Joshua said to Achan, "Why have you brought trouble on us? The Lord will now bring trouble on you." And all the Israelites stoned Achan and his family and burned their bodies. They piled a great heap of stones over Achan, which remains to this day. That is why the place has been called the Valley of Trouble ever since. So the Lord was no longer angry. May the Lord have a blessing to an understanding of his word.
Thank you, Mary and Luis, for sharing hope reading the scripture. I'd like to share some announcements that you may want to be aware of for the week. There is a church board meeting on Tuesday at 6:30. For any of you that like to attend and see how the business of the church is done. Sign up for Wednesday night dinner. This week's menu includes spaghetti, tossed salad, garlic bread, and a whole lot of fun. The Christian Life Development Center classes start at 6:15. Articles for the November issue of Connections are due on Friday, October 20th. Good News Club could use some help with refreshments. If you're able to give them a hand, talk to Jean Schaller. The Outreach Ministry is collecting travel-sized toiletries. Items are listed in the bulletin and the newsletter. Individually wrapped candies are requested for the Fellowship Ministry for the goodie bags for the Harvest Party, which occurs on October 30th. Make your appointment today to get your picture taken for the new director. Donna will be waiting in the lobby. She's setting up time frames so that you can schedule your day to come in, spend 10 or 15 minutes here, get your picture shot, and you're gone. And if you have the opportunity to join Pastor Jeff at the Dover Family Policy Council meeting at Grotto's on October 19th, please plan to do so. He's buying. Let him know today if you can attend.
Tell me you're coming, I'll buy you.
The class Kairos that was planned for the upcoming distant future has been canceled. And next Sunday school will be at the normal time frame. And the service is a combined service in this hour. And that's before the reception that we've planned for Pastor Jeff immediately following that after this service next Sunday. So we're hoping you are all planning to attend that. And you look like you had something to say. Maybe not. With that, we will call our ushers forward to receive this morning's tithes and offerings, as God has been so good to each and every one of us. This is an opportunity for us to give back to Him so that He's able to further develop His kingdom.
And I was thinking back to when did this all start, and I said, well, it was the Sunday that Mark Rajurjan Smith came to speak, and I think it was at Christmas time or in January this past year that he was here. I can't remember the date. And of course, you know, his emphasis as our regional is on missions. So of course he talked about missions and the opportunities that there are out there. So we got talking. The three of us were talking. Flor, Mark, and I were talking together, and Flor's like, well, I really want to go. And I'm like, really? You want to go? I'm like, all right, well, let's look and see what we can find out. So I get online, and all the technology are, it's like, okay, well, we got to owe some money in April. I said, well, we got money in the budget, so let's get going. And then, you know, the rest of you followed through, and you guys helped center the West the way of the trip. So, and then Pastor Xavier, this, you know, he plans, you know, the sermons through the months, and he's like, well, we need a missionary speaker. Who are we going to have? And I said, who are we going to have right here? Flora's going to be our missionary speaker for the month, so come on and share your trip with all of us. I'm looking forward to hear, because I've only had little tidbits, but I can't wait to hear. Thank you.
Papa!
Praise God. Praise the Lord. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
First of all, I want to say thank you to everybody. Thank you for your support, for your prayers, for your encouraging letters that you gave me. Every time I wrote them, it kept me feel like I was at home. I was with you guys, and I know you were praying for me the whole time, and I thank you. I thank you because without you, probably I could go to the mission trip, and everybody took part of this mission trip with me, because some people helped me with money, other people helped me with prayer, with word of courage, and some people gave me clothes too. Quiero darle las gracias a todos ustedes porque ustedes han sido parte de este ministerio y de este viaje a Nicaragua, a esta misión en Nicaragua. Y quiero agradecer a todos los que me han dado con donaciones, con dinero, e incluyendo ropa. Me dieron ropa también. Muchas gracias por eso. Ustedes han tomado parte en este viaje. Thank you very much. This morning I want to share with you a word of God that God put in my heart, and it's in the book of Acts, chapter 1, verse 6 to 8. And the word says, therefore, when they had come together, they asked him, saying, Lord, will you at this time restore the kingdom to Israel? And he said to them, It is not for you to know times or seasons which the Father has put in his own authority, but you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses to me in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the end of the earth. En el libro de Hechos, capítulo 1, al verso 6 y 8, dice, entonces, habiéndose reunido, les preguntaron, diciendo, Señor, ¿restaurarás ahora el reino de Israel? Y él les dijo, no es para vosotros saber tiempos ni estaciones que el Padre ha puesto en su propia potestad, pero ustedes recibirán poder cuando haya venido sobre ustedes el Espíritu Santo, y me serán testigos en Jerusalén, en Samaria, en Judea, hasta los confines de la tierra. Have you ever wondered, why are you here? What is the purpose of being here? What role do you play in this world, in the community, in this church? Each of us has a reason, a purpose to be on this planet. We're not here just to be here. We are here to fulfill the purpose
planeta. Nosotros estamos aquí para llenar y para llevar a cabo el propósito de Dios. Why am I here? What is the purpose? Sometimes we just lost the idea, or we just lost the purpose of God, why God created us. And we just lost that purpose because we're keeping looking at the world, and we start doing what the Lord is, the world is doing. And we just go this way and leave the purpose. That why we are here. We are the church. And God has calling us with a purpose. His purpose is to proclaim this gospel. To teach the people about Jesus. To help others. To give testimony. To testify about the Lord. That's why he said, I give you or you will receive power. When the Holy Spirit come upon you. But you're not going to receive power just because being sitting on chairs. You're not going to receive this power and you're going to keep this power with you. Jesus said that you're going to receive power when the Holy Spirit come upon you. For what? To be a witness. And you're going to be my witness. Where? In Jerusalem. First of all, in your house. First of all, in your community. First of all, with your neighbors. First of all, in your church. And then you're going to be witness in Judea, in Samaria, and all over the earth. This morning, I want to talk about the purpose of our call. But before, I want to let's bow our head and pray. Oh God, we thank you for this day. I pray that your spirit will take control to this moment. Fill us with your presence. We are your church. Give us a fresh anointing of your Holy Spirit to fulfill your purpose in this world. In Jesus' name, we pray. When I made my decision to follow Jesus, God placed in my heart the call to share his gospel. Cuando yo tomé mi decisión de seguir a Jesús, Jesús puso en mi corazón el llamado a predicar el evangelio. He has given me the opportunity to share his message in different ways. En different places, Él me ha dado la oportunidad de compartir su mensaje en diferentes lugares de formas diferentes. In my walk with God, I understood that I was created for Him. I'm not belong myself. I belong to God. You are belong to God. En mi caminar con Dios he aprendido que yo no me pertenezco a mí. Yo le pertenezco a Dios. Le pertenecemos a Dios. Some Christians walk through life without any directions, no purpose in life. If a person does not have clearly defined goals, it is not surprising that he or she will adopt a lifestyle without definition or purpose. Cuando una persona vive sin propósitos, lo único que esa persona va a hacer es vivir la vida sin definición, sin sentido. Y no va a hacer nada. God's plan is to reveal his love and compassion to a lost world. And he has chosen us. And not only that, but he has given us power through the Holy Spirit, so that we are witness of his love and compassion. Dios nos tiene el plan de revelarnos su amor. Dios tiene el plan de revelar su amor a esta humanidad que se pierde. Y Él nos ha escogido a nosotros y nos ha dado de su poder, del Espíritu Santo, para que le podamos testificar a otros del amor de Dios. A purpose on earth is not to get lost in the dark in our journey through life, but to be a beacon of light so that others may find the way. Nuestro propósito en la tierra no es vivir nuestra vida en la oscuridad, sino ser luces en las tinieblas. And who is the way? Jesus is the way. And our purpose in life is not living our life in the darkness, but be a light for this world. And show them that there is a way for them, and Jesus is the way. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Jesús dijo, yo soy el camino, la verdad y la vida. Y nadie viene al Padre si no es a través de mí. Y el propósito de Dios, and God has purpose for you individually, as a person. God has purpose for the church. And we are not alone. He sent us His Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is with us. The Holy Spirit is here to teach us how to do God's purpose. The Holy Spirit is in you and is with you. Jesus came to this earth and lived among men. He fulfilled His purpose of dying on the cross to give us abundant life. But He left, and now you and I are the ones here. Jesús vino a esta tierra a cumplir su propósito de morir en la cruz. Pero Él se fue. Y ahora tú y yo estamos aquí para cumplir el propósito de Dios. We're not alone. The Holy Spirit was sent to be with us. God is seeking people who are willing to fulfill His purpose here on earth. Dios está buscando personas que estén dispuestas a cumplir su llamada, su propósito aquí en la tierra. You will receive power to be witness to me. Tú vas a recibir poder para ser testigos de mí, dijo Jesús. When I went to Nicaragua during my time in La Consulta, I was able to experience what Jesus is saying in this passage. You will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witness. Yo pude tener la experiencia cuando estaba en Nicaragua, en La Consulta y en Rancho Pando, cuando Jesús dice en este pasaje, tú vas a recibir poder cuando haya venido sobre ti el Espíritu Santo. I have learned that the power of the Holy Spirit comes upon us every time God commands us to do something. Yo he aprendido que el poder del Espíritu Santo viene sobre nosotros cada vez que Dios te manda a hacer un trabajo. The Holy Spirit doesn't come just one time upon you. The Holy Spirit comes upon you every time you're going to do something for the Lord. You're not alone. We got the Holy Spirit. You don't have to be afraid to talk about the gospel. You don't have to be afraid to talk about Jesus. It doesn't matter what people will think about you. It doesn't matter what your friends at school, your friends and your job, they will think about you. You got the power of the Holy Spirit in your life. You are somebody special because God is with you and you represent God in this world. We are the ambassador of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We are somebody special. And people need the church. People people need you. Are we going to go like, are we going to go with the flow that the world is going? Are we going to live two lives? I'm Christian, but I'm here with the world practicing things that you're not supposed to. You cannot be witness of the power of the Lord if you live in two lives. Or either you are Christian or either you are not Christian, but don't say that you are and you are not giving testimony about what the Lord is doing in your life. God has promised us His Holy Spirit. God has promised us that we are going to receive power every time you're going to open your mouth. Every time you're going to feed the poor. Every time you're going to talk about the Lord to a little kid. Every time you're going to teach somebody. Every time you're going to visit the sick people that is in the hospital. Every time you're going to visit somebody at their house. When you feel that feeling that the Holy Spirit is putting in your heart to help somebody, just do it. Go ahead, do it. Because you're not alone. Obey God. Dios te ha llamado con el propósito de que tú seas su representante aquí en la tierra. Y cuando tú vas al hospital a visitar a los enfermos, Dios va contigo. No tengas miedo de lo que vas a hablar cuando abras tu boca. Porque el Espíritu de Dios está sobre tu vida y el poder del Espíritu Santo te llena para que te use para ser embajador de Jesucristo. Porque la gente está cansada y la gente quiere en este mundo personas verdaderamente cristianas que puedan representar verdaderamente bien el Evangelio. I have learned that the power of the Holy Spirit comes upon us every time God commands us to do something. He did it with the apostle. He did it with Philip when he went to help the Ethiopian. I experienced that this passage every time we visit places in La Consulta. Yo experimenté este pasaje cada vez que fuimos a visitar lugares en La Consulta. I experienced the presence of God when I was talking with the little kids, when I was singing, when I was teaching them songs. I experienced it, and I feel this happiness inside of me. I was feeling this feeling, this beautiful feeling that you can feel in your stomach, this joy. Because there is a joy when you are doing God's way. There is a joy when you're doing God's purpose. Have you ever feel that joy? How do you feel when you, and I'm telling you this because that happened to me before. Sometimes I wake up and I say, I'm so tired, I'm not going to do nothing today. I'm not going to clean house, I'm not going to cook, I'm not going to do anything. I'm going to take this day for me. And I lay down on that couch and 1, 2, 3 hours, 4 hours, 3, 6 hours, and I feel sick. And I feel horrible inside. I feel like I waste my time. Oh, but when I'm doing something, cooking for somebody who needs to eat something, visiting somebody who's in the hospital, calling somebody and say, how you doing, sis? How you doing, brother? It's a beautiful feeling. You and Paul and the purpose of God, and this is what God is calling us as a church to do His purpose. Do you have purpose in your life? If you don't have purpose in your life, today is your day that you need to think about it. You need to think about it and say, no, today I'm going to stand up and say, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. I'm here for you.
tell me what to do, and I will do it. I will obey. Don't waste your time in earth. Do something for the Lord. Do something for the little kids. Do something for others. I want to share this right away with you. My mom got sick the last time she went to the hospital. And I'm sharing this with you so you can see how much impact a visit to somebody. I was so tired, so frustrated with the situation with my mother. I thought I gonna lose her. And I haven't eaten that for I didn't eat well for 2 weeks. And I was so tired. I was smelling so bad because I didn't have time even to take a shower. I don't mind to say that. Because I was so busy with my mother, days and night. They keep calling me because she don't speak English. And she was screaming and yelling and they said, we don't know what to do. Can you come on, please? And it was 12 at night. And I had to leave my bed and go over there. It wasn't easy. But this one day, I wasn't expecting anybody in there. The pastor was there, Pastor Jeff. He was with his church. He said, I'm coming from the gym. He was sweating. I didn't care. When I saw Pastor Jeff, it was like I took a Tylenol. And the headache left. For real. I was so happy. He didn't notice that. He didn't know the impact his visit did to me. Not for my mother. My mother was, whoo. My mother with the medicine, my mother was, whoo. She didn't notice that he went to visit her. But I did. And he said, Flor, do you eat? I'm okay. Do you want coffee? You like coffee? Yeah, okay, Pastor Goki. And he ran and brought me coffee. A blessing to have a pastor like that. It is a blessing to have a church like that. So let me tell you, brothers and sisters, let me tell you something. Do whatever God's putting in your heart. Do it. Do it because you're not alone. Don't think, how am I going to say this? Don't say, look at me. I don't speak English. But do it and believe that the Lord is with you. Yo quiero decirle que es tan impactante cuando usted hace una visita a alguien, cuando usted le hace una visita al hospital a una persona. Mi mamá estuvo tan enferma y de repente yo no esperaba esa visita y el pastor llegó a visitarlo. A visitar a mi mamá y mi mamá no se dio cuenta. Pero yo sí me di cuenta. Y fue tan impactante para mí, fue como que me tomé una Tylenol. Me sentí bien. Y él no se dio cuenta. Pero cuando él se fue, yo dije, wow, thank you, gracias. Así de impactante es cuando usted hace algo para el Señor. Y eso, and that creates a happiness in your heart. You have a purpose now. You feel good inside. You feel good. I want to feel good. My life now, it has a meaning. Your life has a meaning? Don't answer that to me. Answer yourself. Jesus says in Luke 4:18, the Spirit of the Lord is on me because he has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim freedom for the prisoners and recovery of sight for the blind, to set the oppressed free. And that same Spirit of God, the way that it was upon Jesus to do all that
so you can proclaim freedom for the prisoners and recovery of sight for the blind. Jesus told his disciples, "But when the Holy Spirit comes to you, you will receive power. You will be my witness in Jerusalem and all of Judea and Samaria and every part of the world." He did it with me in La Consulta. The purpose of you and me to be here is to represent Jesus here on earth. And before I show you the video, I want to leave you with this. For many, the only Jesus they will see will be you. For many people, and I'm telling you something, I'm so sure, I'm very sure that those kids in La Consulta, those people in La Consulta, what they are remembering right now is all of the people, all of the mission people we went over there. Because when we were there, it was like when you go and see somebody, a popular singer, and you see all these people, whoa! Well, for the 7 days at La Consulta, we were all those people in there. And they woke up, the little kids, they woke up at like 6 in the morning. They left the place like almost 12 at night. We were so tired, and we were saying, we have to say sometimes, "Please, can you leave? Go home and sleep. We will continue tomorrow." They were so happy, they don't want to leave. It was so beautiful. And I thank you for that. And this is my way to say thank you to you. I want to take you for a moment to La Consulta. Este es mi forma de decir gracias a todos ustedes y por haberme ayudado. Quiero llevarlo por un momento a Nicaragua, a La Consulta.
People, I want you to listen for a moment to the sound that I have to live with. Spirit this morning, you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you. And the Holy Spirit has come on you. And there are a few ways. I don't even know if you even notice the way that the Holy Spirit works among you sometimes. Many of us have been praying before. I think that prayer has already been answered with the power of the Holy Spirit. But did you also notice that Flora was speaking English, and then she'd go to Spanish, and then she'd go to English, and then she'd go to Spanish. Of course, because we have Jose and Edith that don't speak English, and they're becoming members of our church. Why? Because when they've been here, they've sensed the power of the Holy Spirit in you. They've sensed Holy Spirit here among us, and even when they couldn't understand the words, the power of the Holy Spirit was speaking, and that's powerful. You know, you are witnesses, sometimes when you don't even realize it. So as we close, we'd like to sing one more song. You'd stand with us, a song that reminds us to rise up and be the witnesses that God has called us to be in the power of the Holy Spirit.